Namaskar and welcome to Adi Yoga. This video is about Swara Yoga, as the title says. There's a little more information that I'm going to put here. Please note that I will not put the entire information of Swara Yoga. Swara Yoga is very important for masses, for everybody to learn, but only if you are dedicated. It is quite destructive in nature also. I will explain this today, how you can use it for your better good. There's more to it than you think. It is only seen with Desh, Kal and Patra. We see the student. Only then the entire information is provided, or the whole journey is started with the student. The knowledge is imparted if the student is ready. In the last video, we discussed about Chandra Nadi and Surya Nadi, Ida and Pingala. Which one is active and what you need to do? Now a little deeper. Even if your Surya Nadi is active, so you think you can do all the activities, physical activities, you can do exercise, you can eat food, you can do other activities as well. But we need to see in Surya Nadi which tattva is active. How do you see that? So first, it's a four-finger rule. Just four finger beneath your nose, under your nose, put your hand and check if you can feel the breath here. Okay, this is fire element. Now let's suppose it passes the distance of 8 fingers, is the air element. If it comes down to 12 fingers, is the earth element. And if it crosses the 12 and reaches to the 16, it is the water element. Ether is blank, plain, no breath. Now what is happening? If Surya Nadi is active and the tattva of fire is active, you're going to burn yourself. Do not take any decision. Do not go out. Relax, chill. Do not do any exercise. Do not do trading, share market. Don't do that. If the air element is active, even then it's going to give you the almost it's going to give you almost the same results, but with the deviation of air element, not only you will disturb yourself with one decision, but that disturbance will prolong for a certain time period. Depends what kind of a decision, or what kind of a decision that you make, whether this was a related with food, that okay, I want to eat this dish or that dish. So that is quite temporary, yeah. So maybe you will get an upset stomach and it will be over in a day. Let's suppose you took the decision of investment for 10 years. Now the disturbance is for 10 years. Now move down to, before we move to Ida. Now you see, if people who are trying to conceive, when Surya Nadi is active in the fire element, conception is going to be very hard. Miscarriage can happen. With air element, there are high chances of miscarriage. With the other element, when the Surya is with fire, 100% miscarriage. When the Surya is with air, chances of miscarriage, if still conceived, pregnancy is going to be a little hard. And the child's birth, when the child comes out, it would have that fiery intensity in it. Anxious. Now move down to Chandra Nadi. If in the Chandra Nadi, fire element is active, still a good point. You can act. You can eat, you can conceive. It'll be good. If in Chandra Nadi, earth element is active, very good for conception. Even in Surya Nadi, if Surya Nadi, earth element is active, again very good time for conception. If you are a yogi, you can make this happen. Both of you and your partner come down to a nadi. I'm going to tell you later on, not today, maybe only to some students. You can create an enlightened child in the womb. Can you imagine that? A child is born and the kundalini is already active. All that they need is one guru when they come out. Who's going to tell them, oh, this is you. This is God. Boom. Enlightened. It can be done. There is some story that I might share only with my students. We are already bringing a child in that nadi program. So when the Sushumna is active, it's destructive in nature. You're definitely going to harm yourself. It is highly advised to sit down. Whenever Sushumna is active, sit down, because it's going to destruct all the chakras, illusions related to chakras, all the maya. It's going to disturb, distort, destroy all this maya, piercing through all the chakras. Do not take any decision. It's the best moment to sit down and meditate. It's only for highly enlightened yogis to act in Sushumna. Initially, I'm advising, sit down. Okay, it's a very powerful journey. For now, just grab this information and try to use it in your life. We'll talk later about other things, and if you want full consultation or full knowledge about it, you should join the Adiyog family. Write me an email. Email ID is in the description. To live your life accurately and wisely. Namaskar.